Hey, what's going on guys, Sandeep here, and if you want to clean install Windows 11 on any PC, then you need to create a bootable flash media with Windows 11 so that you can insert that flash media into any PC and install Windows 11. But before I show you the process, you need to know about firmware, that is BIOS and UEFI, and disk partition style, that is MBR and GPT. So that you can find how you are going to format your USB flash drive. Now you need to know the basic difference between BIOS and UEFI firmware and MBR and GPT, which are disk structure. So BIOS is an older firmware embedded into the motherboard of your PC. So BIOS firmware always supports MBR, that is Master Boot Record Disk. Disk having master boot record, which loads bootloader, then kernel, then operating system. So BIOS will always support MBR disk structure only. On other hand, UEFI, that is Unified Extensible Firmware Interface, is a new type of firmware embedded on the motherboard of your laptop or PC, which supports GPT disk structure only. GPT, that is GUID partition table. So the UEFI system will always support GPT disk, which contains bootloader into the partition table, which directly access kernel then load the operating system. And UEFI GPT combination is a newer type of standard, which is quite faster and have multiple advantage over BIOS and MBR combination. So it is advised to use UEFI and GPT combination. And Windows 11 will support only UEFI with GPT disk. Now what about USB flash drive? What type of structure do you need for USB flash drive so that you can easily install Windows 11 on UEFI system? UEFI system means UEFI firmware plus GPT disk. So the USB flash drive is also a type of disk which can be MBR or GPT. And the file system inside this disk could be FAT32 or NTFS. Now, if you format your USB flash drive as MBR and FAT32 combination, then it will work with BIOS and UEFI system in most cases. And if you format your USB flash drive as MBR and NTFS file system, then it may not boot with some UEFI firmware. There is a myth that NTFS system won't work with UEFI. However, not all firmware manufacturers include the support for NTFS file system. But some motherboard manufacturers include the support for NTFS file system on UEFI firmware. Now, if you format your USB flash drive as GPT with FAT32 file system, then it will work with UEFI system. And again, the GPT and NTFS file system does not work with most of the UEFI system because not all manufacturers include the support for NTFS file system on UEFI firmware. Now you may be wondering that what type of disk structure and file system you need for your USB flash drive so that you can install Windows 11 on UEFI system. So the answer is you need a GPT disk with FAT32 file system. And you can also use MBR and FAT32 file system in most cases because you are not going to install Windows 11 on your USB flash drive. You just want to boot from USB flash drive and copy all the files from flash drive to the GPT disk of your PC. But it is recommended to use GPT and FAT32 file system for your USB flash drive. Now here's another problem, that is FAT32 file system has a limitation that you won't be able to copy a file larger than 4 GB because Windows 11 ISO contains a file install.vim which is larger than 4 GB. Now you need a workaround so that you can create two partitions into your USB flash drive. One partition would be FAT32 which will contain bootloader and some other files, and other partition will be NTFS and it will contain larger file, that is install.vim and some other files. And you can achieve this workaround using a third-party tool called Rufus and using CMD. In this video, I will demonstrate Rufus only. In next video, I will show you the CMD method. So I have inserted my flash drive. You need a flash drive having at least 8 GB of storage and Windows 11 ISO file. I already have downloaded it And if you want to download it, I have a video for that, go watch it. Once you have ISO file downloaded, you need to extract all the contents of this ISO file using WinZip or WinRAR. I have already extracted all the contents of ISO file inside this folder. Now you need to download Rufus tool. You can always search on Google, or the link is provided in the video description. It is a free tool having 3.5 MB file size, and I already have downloaded the tool. So let me open the tool. So just download Rufus and open it. You don't have to install the software. It is a portable tool. So once you open the Rufus, you will see this interface. Now you have to select your USB flash drive. If you have multiple USB flash drive connected, then select the target USB flash drive. Then select your ISO file, Windows 11 ISO file. Now the partition scheme should be GPT, because you are going to install Windows 11 on UEFI system. And target system will autofill, that is UEFI, if you select GPT. You don't have to change these options. Now you can name your USB flash drive anything you want. I will type Windows 11. Now you can see that file system is selected as NTFS, but you know that NTFS won't work with UEFI system. Rufus is going to create a small FAT32 partition inside your USB flash drive, which will contain the bootloader. And this small FAT32 partition won't be visible to you. And you don't have to mess with advanced option, just click on start. Click on OK, it is going to erase all the data from your USB flash drive. Now it will take some time, around 20 to 30 minutes, you have to wait for that. Now the process is complete, Windows 11 USB flash drive is ready to install Windows 11. You will get this notice that UEFI NTFS bootloaders requires you to disable secure boot, but Windows 11 requires you to enable secure boot. There may be some problem with some UEFI system. Now you can try to boot this USB flash drive on UEFI system and install Windows 11. It should work with most of the UEFI system. However, some UEFI system may not support this method. So you can see that USB flash drive is ready on my system. Let me remove it and insert it again. And you can see that getting Windows installation logo. That means it is a bootable disk. Now let's open the disk management window and check the property of USB flash drive. So this is a USB flash drive removable disk, which is disk 2. Let's go to properties, then volume. You can see that it has GPT partition style, and you can also see that it has two volumes. One is NTFS and other is FAT32, which is not visible. So the FAT32 system is required to boot on UEFI system. And that's all about BIOS, UEFI, MBR, GPT, FAT32, NTFS, and the compatibility with your bootable USB flash drive. So this is how you can create Windows 11 bootable media, and in the next video, I will show you the command prompt method. That's all for this video guys, hope this helped. If so, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon to get notified about new videos, and I will see you in my next video.